How about a motion to approve the proposed municipal organization chart in concept?
Following overpayment of tax payment in total of $1,325.92 needs to be approved for refund in accordance with the provisions of Section 12-129 of the Connecticut General Statutes. Dated at Seymour, the 13th day of April, 2017, Susan Boland, Assistant Tax Collector.
That was silky smooth. Wow. Okay. I am. That was something nice, Len. I want to sit by a fire and listen to a book you're reading. Wow. That's something.
Sounds like you should be on the radio.
I know. Definitely on the AM dial. Yeah.
Do some voice work.
Wow, look at that. He's red. He's embarrassed. Okay, with that, I'll entertain a motion to accept the April 13, 2017 Tax Collector's Report as presented. Motion by Nicole, second by Anne Marie. Under discussion, just review, make sure there's no conflicts. Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained? Chair votes aye. Motion passes 7-0. Item number 15 is transfers. We have no transfers before us this evening. Item number 16 is correspondence. We have some correspondence before us tonight. We have the check register, I said that wrong. We have a letter to myself from the tax collector with the Jeopardy, tax collections. You can see that there. And we have a letter to the board, to myself, and to Rory with CCs to Town Clerk Susan DeBarber, Bonnie Wilkes, D. Caruso, and Fred Massori from resident Joseph A. Luciano. And has to do with downtown curb cuts with bad landings and sidewalks with steep cross slopes and roller coaster rises must be demolished and replaced for public safety and or ADA compliance. And you can see his attached letter. There are also some pictures, and he is claiming that curb cuts that were put into the new sections in downtown are not ADA compliant. So he had asked us to include this as a part of public comment, so that will be included with the minutes and attached as public comments. Okay. That does correspondence. So with that, we will move on to item number 17, which is public comment. John, we'll start with you. Name and address for the record. Into the microphone, please.
John Stelma, Peoria Lane. First, I want to thank everybody for all the time that they put into the issue on our small cities rehabilitation. I know it was a lot of effort on your part. I just had a couple of comments. The first on the driveway, and I just wanted to make a clarification on the driveways, that the driveways were done by one contractor, but they were subcontracted to another one as well. That I don't think has been brought up at all. So I don't know, even if we did our due diligence and looked up on the Better Business Bureau and everything else on the contractor that we got, it wouldn't have shown up on our driveways that the subcontractor was on it. So that's number one. Number two, on the contracts, when future people go to sign them, if there's any way that they can review them ahead of time, basically we were told that our appointment would be 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. We came in and we had a brief moment to absorb everything in the contract, 35 pages. I think it would be helpful if people had a chance to review it and then come, and if they had any questions, have somebody that can answer their questions. Last one is some of the items that I have. I didn't have a lot of the issues with things falling apart. The only basic issue I have left, since the contractor was here again Monday, yesterday, to fix up some of the final things that weren't done. The only issues I had would be mainly paperwork, and I'm not sure if that's something the contractor would be in charge of or if it's the consultant itself. And that's the bidding process that we were asking for, the warranties that we were asking for, and then the individual itemized bill would be contractor, that one I finally did receive. And then the time for the start of the project to the end of the project, according to the contract, is 60 days. My driveway started in September. It's just gotten finished this week, so that's almost 6 months. And other than that, they've been trying to get some of the other items remedied. So I think I'm pretty well at 95% of everything being done according to the contract. It's just the driveway and the paperwork that's the holdup on mine. So I thank you again for all your diligence.
Thank you, Jim. Is there any other public comments, Ron?
George Noe, Ten Rocky Glen. Just a couple of questions. If the town is offering this grant, why aren't they responsible as to, did the town attorney read the contract before it was offered to the citizens? Or if not, why is the town involved at all? Because we obviously owe you people a mortgage or a lien. So that would be one of my questions. How, if you're saying you're not involved, why do we owe you one? The second is the bids. I never received any copies of the bids. I don't know if one guy bid, four guys bid. I don't know how many there were and what the dollar amounts were. So I'm not privy to that. And why does not the homeowner have some kind of involvement in the bids when they're open? When I had a discussion with Lisa Lowe on the phone, she told me that if you didn't like the lowest bid, you could take the next bid up and pay the difference. Now that was verbal, so I have no proof of that. Just tell you what happened. And the third is, where were the inspections before there were any payments made? If I believe in the contract, there's somewhere when the job is 50% completed, it's supposed to be inspected, and then the town would start issuing payments. I never saw any inspections at my property. The fourth is, I've never received any warranties on anything. I don't have a warranty on my oil tank. the electrical. I have warranties on nothing. The third is that oil tank problem. I don't even know where to go here. I could tell you that right now, I'm not going to let the contractor on my house, on my property. I don't trust this gentleman. I wouldn't even allow him to mow my lawn. So I don't know what I'm going to do with that permit yet, but I'm going to think it over, and I might have to find some other avenue for it. But I can assure you, I was not happy with this contractor, and I wasn't happy with this whole process now looking back. Well, that doesn't mean much, but that's all I have to say.
Thank you.
Is there any other public comment?
Kevin Flaherty, 29 Emma Street. If you look at the mission statement on these projects, they're supposed to be designed for the elderly, the disabled, and veterans. So you're telling me that as long as you can drag somebody back there to sign, doesn't matter if you have attention deficit disorder, doesn't matter if you have post-traumatic stress disorder, doesn't matter if you're blind, don't matter if you can't hear. In other words, you're looking at issues that are important to people, but as long as you can drag them back there and sign it, it's good then. Is that correct? Is that the way it goes? Second thing, I forced the issue with the Department of Housing. I won't go through this whole thing, but I'm going to go over a couple of issues here. Doorknob almost fell off. Homeowner mentioned one doorknob almost fell off. DOH action. There was a loose screw that was tightened by the homeowner for homeowner's statement, according to Lisa Lowe Associates. DOH considers this issue closed. Vinyl, torn and bubbling. According to Lisa Lowe Associates, vinyl tiles were installed properly. Homeowner was moving refrigerator across the floor against casters and tearing. Contractor returned to repair rips twice after second repair. Contractor offered to replace flooring at no additional cost if the homeowner wished to purchase new material to install. According to LLA, when contractor went to the house, bubbles were not found on the floor. They're there. Homeowner cannot find bubbles unless the homeowner finds the problem of installation. DOH considers this issue closed. Warranty. I forced the issue with a warranty. DOH action. One thing the homeowner learned from DOH staff was that homeowner should have a warranty for a work with a start date and end date. And I got that from Dimple Desai. Unfortunately, mine's already halfway done. If I sold you a car for $90,000 and I told you, guess what, come back and see me in 6 months for the warranty, that's good. That would be fine with everybody, right? Homeowner has provided warranty information. Part of the contract was signed on June 1st. According to LLA warranty paperwork, went out on March 23rd. The warranty for work done on the homeowner began October 31st, 2016, and expires on October 31st, 2017, based on the final payment check. Just got this. So my warranty is already half over. That's a fair deal. Thanks.
Janice Hamm, 29 Emma Street. In the contract, at one point, and I can't even tell you what section it was, but I had read that halfway through, we are supposed to, the project person from Lisa Lowe's office is supposed to come out and check things out. That never happened because I was there every day while the contractor was there. Also in the contract, it was saying, before any money is given to the contractor, I know you have to give upfront money to get, you know, so they can get the materials and stuff. But before they close the job, the project manager from Lisa Lowe's office and the building inspector here are supposed to go through the house. Our permits were not pulled for the job until January, I think it was January 23rd. He came out January 29th to inspect. Supposedly, the job was done October 31st. You see a problem. Our warranties, like Kevin just said, we just received them March 27th. Is there a problem? Yes. As far as the contract, I think if the town is going to continue with the process, either have somebody trained to sit with the people, because like Kevin was saying, it's for seniors. They can have dementia a little bit. For vets and for disabled people. Some people don't understand what they're signing. Unfortunately, we had a little too much trust in the process, and we're getting screwed by it. Kevin was pressured into signing it so he could get it upstairs to get it notarized. He didn't have a chance to bring it home and check out all 32 pages. It's shame on him for not taking the time, but it's shame on Lisa Lowe's people for not allowing people to take the time. We wouldn't be here. And as far as my vinyl, I don't even know what to think right now. We're ready to go and get a different contractor and have somebody else lay it, the vinyl. But that's going to cost us even more money. There is a bubble. I talked to another contractor that does this for a living. He said if the vinyl was laid properly, there should have been no problem with me moving the refrigerator. And I'm not a he-man. I don't just pull it out. I have to inch it out. So there should not have been any tears. The only thing I can think of is they might have used enough glue, but they might have had too much vinyl. So when you pulled it, you know, like you have a piece of paper, and if it's not set down straight, it wrinkles, and they can get tear that way. The bubble is there. Roger never saw it because he did not give me time. Because I can tell him right where it is. So I don't trust the contractor. I don't want him back in my house either. He's lied on many things. Like, we move the refrigerator often. Do I really want to move my refrigerator often? No. We do it about 3 times a year because we have dogs. I have to clean underneath it. Thank you for your time. Let's see what you can do.
Sorry for losing my temper here, but it's just a really frustrating process. I only have one copy of this from HUD, but I'll gladly turn it in. You guys can go through and see the great information. The gospel according to St. Lisa.
We'll make copies. Is there any other public comment? Name and address for the record.
John Maiorino, 38 Emma Street in Seymour. I spoke to the lawyer here just off the record, but maybe it should be on the record. Is that when these people take a contract, contractor A signs the contract to do X amount of work. Who says he can't go out and hire some shyster on the street? I've seen that done because I used to be a builder. And just, you know, hire somebody that's not qualified. Does HUD look into the subcontractor? Because when she was talking about that linoleum job, I've seen a lot of linoleum put down. They either didn't use the proper mastic, or they didn't use the proper, like you have an eighth inch, quarter inch, whatever, but it's evenly, has to be put down evenly, and then rolled with, a linoleum roller is real, real heavy. You start from the center and you roll it out to the edges, so if there is any air bubble, you push it out. So whoever installed it certainly was not a linoleum installer. I've never seen it in my life, and I've seen a lot of linoleum put down. So it isn't the contractor. The contractor who signed the contract, did he do the work that he signed for? And if he sent it out to some unqualified person, I've seen contracts where a contractor goes out, gets people off the street, them having a soul care. You're a carpenter, bricklayer, buying some new trowels. You're a bricklayer, working on school jobs. I've seen that happen. Somebody's got to be responsible for that. We're the subcontractors legally qualified to do the work. Maybe the contractor was, but who done the work? Were they carpenters? Were they masons? Were they plumbers? Were they electricians? Nobody knows. Anybody could have done it. And that's why I feel sorry for these people. My estimation, like I said at one meeting I was back here before, not only a scam, I would call it criminal. It's just terrible. Never seen work like that. And I don't know who the inspector was. Anybody come in and inspect the casing on the window, on the door, right? To cut it short and put a patch on it. You can walk in and look at it, take that window. Somebody come in and say, oh, yeah, it looks good. But maybe the guy only put in maybe a couple of nails, one top and bottom. 6 months, it'll fall off. Well, it's code. You know, it matches. It looks good. The quality was terrible. 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 And the money that they paid for this.
Is there any other public comment?
Why isn't somebody back there when the contract signed besides just Lisa Lowe's representative? That's what I'd like to know. I went to the town of Ansonia. Ellen Tershman sits in when a contract signed. According to the Record Journal, Mark Farlazzi's there when a contract signed. So why are you just throwing somebody in there? Like I said, you don't know if they're disabled, if somebody has issues. I just think it's a shame, and I'll leave it at that.
Is there any other public comment? Is there any other public comment? Whatever you'd like to speak about, Mr. Flynn.
Michael Flynn, 85 Skokorat Street. I think in light of the accident or tragedy that we saw in Seymour, you know, we're not here to judge who's right or who's wrong, but I think as the town has a right to protect and save lives, the pedestrians and those who are driving cars, you know. It's not for us to judge, you know, whether the person was right or wrong. I think we should install speed bumps on certain major arteries in this town. We only have so many police to patrol these areas, and we have an obligation to save life. And I think if there were speed bumps up there, the people who were speeding probably would have been alerted somewhat to what they were doing, would have slowed them down. It does create a source of consternation to somebody who wants to go 65 miles an hour in a 45 mile zone and they hit that speed bump. It's a shock. It's a cultural shock, but it wakes them up. I think it's something we should consider on many of the main arteries, speed bumps. I know it might be a hindrance to fire departments, emergency services, but there's pros and cons in everything, you know. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Flynn. Is there any other public comment?
I understand they're going to be doing some work on Emma Street, repaving Emma Street this year. Before they do it...
Can't answer, but...
No, but before they do it, I wish somebody would come down and talk to me about what the problem is there before they... They paved Emma Street twice, and each time they made the situation worse. And it has to be ground down before it's done. The second time that they paved, they told me they were going to do that. They came by... I think I showed you that hump. Mm-hmm. The water can't even get to the catch basin. And it's all going to come down my driveway. Not the insurance you have now, but the insurance company way back had to pay for a whole new garage foundation for him. And he's sitting there. But the next day, they had a different insurance company. Who dropped? Whether the insurance company dropped Seymour or Seymour dropped them, I don't know. But when they saw what happened, and it was never fixed. So I wish they would just come and look at it. I think I showed you.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. Yep.
Yeah,
yeah, Brian's aware of that.
I hope they just don't come and do it.
No.
Thank you.
Well, any other public comment? Any other public comment? Asking one last time. Any other public comment? Nope. Okay, we'll close public comment. We'll go to Selectman's public comments. Steph, we'll start with you.
I've spoken my fair share tonight.
Okay. Karen.
I just have two things I'd like to say. One, I agree with Mr. Flynn. It was a horrible accident. However, I taught high school for 33 years, and it was six 16-year-old wants to go 70 miles an hour, I don't care what the road looks like. They're going to speed. And you notice, I hope, that none of the passengers in the car, the new driver, were from SEMA. What were they doing in that neighborhood?
Mr. Flynn, we can't have... Sorry. Get me in trouble.
Well, I'm not looking for an answer. I'm simply...
Well, I know... Brian Nesteriak is doing the lot set for Mountain and Bungay Road, and he is looking at speed humps, I'll call them, not speed bumps,
okay,
in an attempt to slow traffic down, particularly by the schools. So I don't know if it's going to be feasible or not, but it's something that he is looking into.
Is there a difference between that and the one they cut in the center of the road?
That's the one he's talking about.
Oh, okay.
No, that's a rumble strip. Instead of the speed bumps are kind of the smaller ones that you basically have to stop and go over. The humps are kind of the bigger, yeah, rounded ones. The problem with the speed bumps is the plows destroy them,
right,
is the problem. So but the humps, if the drivers know where they are, they can get over them a little easier with the plows. So, but we're definitely looking at that. I don't know if it's going to happen, but it's something that's being looked at.
Okay. The only other thing I have, this is more a question than a comment. I've noticed, now that I'm retired and out and about, we have a lot of vacant space in town. We have businesses moving in and moving out. And I was wondering, is there some way we can get a report as to what businesses are being courted or solicited to come into town? I've heard several rumors,
mm-hmm,
and also, and I'm not going to name names, if this would include all seven of us, I think, that we had Seymour Lumber torn down because we hate the family. And that's what I was told flat out to my face, and it was said to me right, I wish Dee was here, she was sitting there, was right outside of your office where the gentleman said it to me. And I didn't know how to respond because I didn't know if there was any, I've heard about, as I say, some rumors,
mm-hmm,
about fast food and other businesses, but is there some way we can get a report as to what kind of action is being taken, maybe on the major parcels of land?
I don't know how accurate the report would be. It would only be as accurate as the information provided to us from the commercial realtors.
Uh-huh.
The only two parcels that I could speak about with any certainty would be Triton Plaza and Housatonic Water. Fred Missouri has had contact with Lou Proto, who represents some of the open space in town. Lou is only somewhat forthcoming with that information because he's trying to protect his clients, as he should.
Yeah.
But we did have someone call the office about Kevin Cox's property across from Webster Bank. What that is for,
I heard that too.
We put them in contact with Kevin. So I could try to put something together, but I wouldn't feel comfortable making it public in this setting because I don't know the accuracy of it. And I wouldn't want to put something out there that's not true. I would know if it was or wasn't, is what I'm saying to you.
I understand what you're saying. I'm just, it's sometimes frustrating, you know, to drive and see all this empty property that maybe we could use a Burger King.
Well, you know, what we would like to see or what we could or couldn't use, the land is owned by private citizens.
I understand that.
And what they want to do with their property is entirely up to them. And like I said, the only two I can speak to any certainty on is Triton Plaza and Housatonic Wire, because I have dialogue with both, but both have asked me not to make public the information they've shared with me.
Okay.
I think we'll see tremendous movement in both in the next probably 2 or 3 months, but I won't say where or what.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome. No problem. I mean, we can have Fred Missouri come and give an update too if you want to have him do that. I mean, that's... Fred and I visited an incubator space in Hamden today. We're actually looking at potentially going after the Bank of America and turning that into a business incubator space. But that's easier said than done. So, but that would be some benefit. So, been there for about 3 hours or so in Hamden today. Lynn?
Yeah, I don't want to beat a dead horse, but you know, obviously we can't legally do anything about the existing contracts with regard to the Small Cities Grant issue. You know, that's unfortunate, but it is, it's the way it is. What we can do moving forward, and I think what we are planning to do, is trying to improve the process, make our side of the process better, smoother, make sure that we hold our contractors, particularly a consultant who seems to be the linchpin of this entire program, ensure that whether it's Lisa Lowe or somebody else, they communicate better, they provide ample amount of time to review contracts and to inform the residents of what is actually in the contracts and ensure that this type of situation doesn't arise again. And we will be doing that. And I'm confident that this board will take the action that we can. And unfortunately, you know, it's a sad state of affairs, but it is the reality. We cannot do anything else for the existing contracts. So, you know, I'm looking forward to hearing what the current consultant has to say. And I'm sure moving forward, we can take the proper steps if necessary to reevaluate the situation. And you know, who knows, maybe this program isn't for Seymour, maybe it is. But from what I understand, there are other people who have taken advantage and they have been happy with it. So hopefully that'll continue. And this is a very unfortunate but small bump in the road. That's it.
Mm-hmm.
No? I just wanted to inquire about the curbing repair around town and what the timeline might be to start repairing that curbing.
Asphalt plants opened about 2 weeks ago, so I wouldn't expect to see anything until probably May at this point.
Okay. And what's the process? You guys are aware of what the process is to identify the curbing? If somebody from Public Works make a trip around town and they plot it out, or
they generally have, they drive their plow routes and they're supposed to be making notes for potholes, road damage, things like that. And then it's evaluated that way. And then also residents call in and say, my curb got blown up by the plow.
And I just want to, the Rise Up event at Seymour Middle School is a success. I want to congratulate Ernie Stacy and his folks there and his team. That was a good time. My wife and my daughter went and said it was just a blast. So. And I think we talked about that last meeting, but I want to make sure that I put in my two cents.
Thank you.
Emory?
Just to touch on the Rise Up, it was the first time I went. My whole family went. I was shocked. It was great. It was wonderful. I can't wait for next year. I'm really kind of disappointed in this board that we did not put an act together.
Stefan's fault.
Not for the lack of Nicole trying, just the lack of certain men on this board.
There was lack of agreement on what we're going to do is what there was.
Like my lover boy idea, but you know, yeah, whatever.
I wasn't in the country.
I also want to welcome Stained Glass, the store, the Glass Source store in a studio in downtown Seymour, right next to Wildflower.
Mm-hmm.
They just opened up. And to touch on to the report, you know, Fred Missouri coming, we're supposed to be getting the quarterly reports from each department, and that kind of has stopped.
We got it.
Mm-hmm.
On the website.
I kind of like it when they came to the meetings.
Who came to the meetings?
When the departments came to the meetings and they gave their reports.
I can't remember the last time that happened.
That's what I kind of like, because this is where we have questions. We
what
ask.
What she said.
Mm. But,
is that your point? That you don't remember the last time it happened?
Yeah. I can't even tell. It's been like,
my point.
Like seven or eight years it's been.
If I have a question...
It's
not been 7 or 8 years, because you did it when you first got into office.
We didn't have them. People would come if you want them to come. Just tell me what departments.
I think Fred was coming for a while.
Yeah.
Right?
Because
he had
the yeah. I remember.
Yeah, Fred was here, what,
yeah.
Last quarter?
Yeah. He was only here about the Greenway for a while.
Yeah.
He wasn't here to give an economic development report. I for one, would love to have him.
I'll give any report.
I would
tell
take
me
an economic development report every single meeting.
No, Rory, fine.
All right, so we'll set Fred up. Rory, could you call Fred and check his availability for one of the next meeting or two? I wasn't being flip, Emery. I just don't recall. I mean, I was maybe a little bit, but.
No, I was
all right, maybe a touch. No, but anyone, we never had them scheduled specifically, this, that, and the other. If you guys want to have specific ones, we'll get them here.
I think that's a good idea.
But we'll get, you get a.
I like it because the fire marshal would come in, and he would give us a quarterly reports on all the permits, on all the activities, on all the inspections he was driven in.
I don't remember.
Shaking his head back.
I honestly don't remember that happening.
And then Reverend Story would come in, and he would give his report.
Yeah, I honestly.
Hasn't happened in a long time.
I don't remember. It's in the executive summary. Sure, just, everybody email me who you'd like to see, and I'll have them all lined up. That's honestly.
You have to beat somebody, they're here in public, and you beat them to their face.
That's not a problem. Just tell me who you want to see.
Okay.
We'll get any department head in you want.
You need that.
Okay. Or you can read the executive summary on the website. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. All right, maybe that was a bridge too far. Nicole.
Hello. Thank you.
Seriously?
All right, a few things. As far as the small cities grant, I'm sorry to all the people that have had issues. I hope that the town, Kurt's office, can reach out to Lisa Lowe just to see if there's anything she can do. I understand that they sign the contracts, and it is between the, you know, the person and the contractors, but if there's an issue with this particular contractor, then something needs to be done. From what I understand, we've never had an issue with any other people that have had this done except right now, so which leads me to believe that it's the contractor, not necessarily the program. Second, Mr. Luciani's comments and pictures that he sent us on the sidewalk grades.
Curb cuts, yeah.
Curb cuts. Have we ever had the grade checked just to make sure it's the correct grade?
By our engineer, yes.
Okay. And has the engineer reached out to Mr. Luciani to let him know that they're...
This just came in the last, like, day or two?
Oh, did it? Okay.
Yeah, this is relatively recent.
And then even the curb cuts, whatever his... I know he's talked about curb cuts before.
He's talked about older curb cuts that needed to be repaired.
Okay, but now he's talking about the new ones, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Which he also said, sent us emails praising us for putting the curb cuts in and how nice they were.
Right.
Now, there's issues with the curb cuts, yeah.
Okay, and...
Some of them.
And the third thing... I did attend the 3rd annual Rise Up event at the middle school. It was well attended. It was a great time. It was a sold out event once again. Mr. DeStacy, Ernie DeStacy, did an amazing job. He spearheaded this 3 years ago with Ed Stramello, a member of our Board of Ed. And if anybody didn't get to go, they have a Facebook page. You can try and look it up that way. But Ernie came in as, I wrote it down. Yeah, he came in like Rocky, and this is my house, and he was dressed in, you know, as a fighter, and he's running through the halls in middle school, and it was great. He's a great actor, he's a wonderful person, and we're very fortunate to have him here in the town of Seymour. So I encourage him to stay here forever. But again, next year, if you can go. And anybody also, too, it's a great program. I encourage it. I am a mentor. I've been in the program since it started 3 years ago. And I encourage people, if you have 1 hour, it's actually a half hour once a week, to mentor some of the kids in our school system. I cannot explain to you the gratification and the feeling you get of being a part of these kids' lives every day. So,
Stephen just got volunteered.
Okay, thank you.
I did have a five-minute.
We got that and another board lined up for it. Rich, anything you want to add? Rory, anything we've missed? No? Any last comments? No? With that, I will...
Make a motion adjourn.
Second.
Motion by Anne Marie, second by Karen. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained? Chair votes aye. Motion passes 7-0. Mark the meeting closed at 9:13 p.m. Yeah. Do you really want to be a mentor?
What?
Actually, that's something.